Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. Recently, OpenAI released a lightweight multi-agent framework called Swarm, which is defined as an experimental and educational project. The purpose of this framework is to allow developers to create chatbot applications that can interact with multiple agents in a more organized and scalable way. From its original blog post of its basic idea and the initial release the repository of this implementation, Swarm introduced several key concepts such as routines, which builds the foundation of this framework that regulate the workflow of each agent with import messages, function calls, model inference, and output messages. And the handoffs, which is the mechanism that allows agents to pass the speech position to another agent. The best practice to use Swarm framework is to build a scenario in which human users can interact with a group of agents, and each agent can perform a specific task, and the system can always delegate the user request to the most suitable agent, such as a customer service chatbot or technical support chatbot. Therefore, building a web UI with sorted visualizations and intuitive interactions for such scenarios become the most critical part of Swarm application. In this tutorial, I will build a simple customer support web app by using Swarm framework and panel library. You will learn how to develop a Swarm-based chatbot as well as equip a web UI for it in a few lines of code. Panel is an open source library that allows developers to create customer web apps for data visualization and interactive computing. Its advantage is that it provides high-level components like widgets and API that facilitate the standard and common interactive app development by users who are not professional web developers. Meanwhile, it also provides low-level API for professional developers to customize or extend the components or styling as their needs. For example, if you go to the component gallery and find the chat family, you will see the top-level components called chat interface, which is a complete chat box with input area, send buttons, and a message list on the main area. If you just want to create a standard chatbot like we will do in this tutorial, you can directly use this component with its default layout and styling. Also, you will see the bottom level like chat message, chat steps, which are the lower level blocks that you can customize its internal logic or internal appearance as you like. Understanding the fundamental concepts of these tools, in this section, I will walk you through the code of a practical application that we will build in this tutorial. Before starting, make sure you have installed the Swarm packages together with the panel framework. And note that you need to install the Swarm packages from the source code. In the code, first input the necessary module that we will use in the code and set the OpenAI API key for the model inference. So in this code, we will separate it into two sections. One section is the initialization of Swarm client and then define the agents. The second section is about the panel UI components and integrate them with these agents. So let's see the first section. Here we will create a Swarm client. You can imagine it like a studio that includes one triage agent and three work agents who will simulate the different customer support functions. The three agents are product information retrieval agent, order status retrieval agent, refund processing agent. Each agent will have its own set of functions and instructions that it can call. So let's start with the definition of these functions. Here we define the three agents' functions, which simulate the product information data source, order status generating, and the answer from the processing of refund. After that, we should define the instructions for each agent. Here we will use the function to define the constructing of the agent instruction and embedding the context variables as placeholders that will field during the runtime. Let's define the context variables. There are two context variables in the dictionary. One is the customer name and the other is last order ID. So we will use that for the workflow of this app. So in the instruction, you can find we ask the triage agent to dispatch the proper work agent according to the customer request type, and product info agent to provide the product details. The order status agent to provide the status and delivery time of order, and the returns refunds agent to process the refunds and explain the policy guide through process, and the customer name will be used in the conversation to let the agent to know who are they talking to, and the order ID will be used for the order status checking or refund process. After finish the routine functions, now we are going to define the agent handoff functions. So these functions are not used to perform the actual task, but defined to explicitly transfer the speech position to a certain agent and carrying the context variables. So it will be used by the triage agent, transfer to product info agent, transfer to order status agent, transfer to returns refunds agent. So it only simply return the result object with the agent name and the context variables. With the routines and the handoff functions are ready, now we can define the agents. So its definition is quite simple. For the triage agent, it has the name, instructions, and the function list. In the function list, we import the three handoff functions for triage agent. So it will only perform the agent orchestration task. And for the rest of the three agent, they will call actual routine function that help them to perform simulation tasks. And also, if you want, one of these work agents are also capable of dispatching further agent, you can also register some of these handoff functions into its function list. So here in the case of a normal swarm application, now the studio can run by a proper agent appointed for speech delegation. Use client run function. However, in this tutorial, we will focus on the UI part so that the client run function will be called later in the UI code. So now let's move on to the second section, which is the implementation of the panel UI. As I mentioned before, we will use the chat interface component for the main chat UI, which already includes a complete chatbot with an input area, a second a send button, and a message list on the main area. So only these three lines can do this work. Find the extension with the design of material, which will shows appearance called material, and create a chat interface by the chat interface constructor. And then for the first message shows on the message UI, there will be a welcome message together with a inquiry of user's name. Then we will define a callback function for processing the user message input. So this function will be called whenever a user send a message after we register this function into the chat interface callback parameter. So in this user message processing function, there will be several steps. First, we will check if the customer name is on. If not, the system will ask for it and reject the user response as a username and append each user message into the message list to query the model inference. Delegate the message to the current agent defined with trash agent and use the client run function to execute the response generation. And the next agent will be determined by the response generated in the current run. Then we call the chat interface send to display the response messages from the current agent in the chat interface. You can find the agent name in the response agent name variable. And then update the message list again with the response messages. If the user message contains the keyword order, we will update a context variable with a random order ID that will be used for the order status checking and the returns and refunds processing, and reject that callback into the chat interface callback parameter. The last step, we should add the chat interface into panel app by calling the chat interface servable. Okay, this is the complete code of this tutorial. Now you can run it by the panel command. Panel serve swarm panel py. You will see a message saying that the panel app is running at port 5006. Now you can try to open the link in your browser to see the appearance of this web UI. So this is the entry page of this simple web UI. So the system asks me to enter the name, Yeyu. And then you will see the triage agent came out to ask me what can it help me. Then I will say, I want to know the new product ID 1. So I want to call the product information agent. Now you see the product information agent came out and listed me the ID 1 of smartphone iPhone 16, which is in the list of get product information function as ID 1. So it means the proper agent has been orchestrated and also the internal function has been executed. Then tell me more about this product. Yeah, it's very funny that the product information agent cannot answer me details about iPhone 16, but actually it's working as a real agent that keeps serving me. So if you are also interested in seeing the function calling procedure in detail, you can also display the tool calling information of the agent by replacing this simple chat interface send call to this process. That in addition to send the message content to the front end and also send the tool calls information with the tool name in the function section of the format to send to the panel UI. Now let's run the code again. So let's check again. Input Yeyu as my name. And I want to know the product ID 1. You will see the triage agent use the tool transfer to product info, which is its handoff function. And then the product information agent came out, use the tool get product info to get the number one ID's name. And then it reply with the product ID 1 is smartphone iPhone 6. So it's more clear for us to see what was going on in our product agent procedures. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.